All right, so you now understood how a vector can be represented using Cartesian components in 2D, right? So now we will learn how to write, how to find the magnitude of vector if we know the vector in Cartesian form. So let's take some sample general vector whose x component, okay, this x component will be x, okay, and its y component will be y. All right. So I can write down this vector as x I cap plus y j cap. Okay. Now in this vector, this length will be equal to x and this height will be equal to y. This is your right angle triangle. So the base is x, the height is y. Okay. So how much is the length of the hypotenuse? So the length of the hypotenuse will be given by under root of x square plus y square, right? And that is actually the length of the vector itself. So if I have in general some r vector is equals to x I cap plus y j cap, then I can write magnitude of this r vector as r, or simply magnitude of r vector, that is equal to root of x square plus y square. That's it, very easy, right? So this is the way of writing magnitude of a vector. So let's take, for example, I have a vector A which is given by 3 I cap plus 4 j cap. You have to write the magnitude of this vector. So it's very easy. A will be under root of x square plus y square. So instead of x we have 3, instead of y we have 4. So we get this to be equal to root of 9 plus 16. That will be root of 25. So magnitude of the vector will be 5. Simple. Now what if there's a negative sign involved? For example, I have a vector B given by let's say 6 I cap minus 8 j cap. How do you solve this? So it's very simple, that B will be equal to root of 6 square. Now there's a minus sign, but when you are squaring it, the minus sign doesn't matter anymore, right? So you could simply write down 6 square plus 8 square. Okay, so this will give you under root of 36 plus 8 times 8 will be 64. So that will be root of 100. So B will be equal to 10. So this vector has magnitude 10. Okay. Okay, now try one simple question. You can pause the video after reading this question. So the question says that C vector is equal to x I cap minus 12 j cap. Find x such that c equal to 30. You can pause this video and try to solve this question yourself. Okay, all right, let's continue. So c will be equal to root of x square plus 12 square. Okay, squaring, so c is basically equal to 13. Now when you square on both the sides, so x square plus 12 square means 144. That will be equal to a square of 13. 13 square is 169. So x square will be 169 minus 144. So this will be equal to 25. Now x square equal to 25. So x can be 5 or minus 5. Both are the possibilities, okay? X could be positive or it could be negative. So my C vector could be 5 I cap minus 12 j cap or minus 5 I cap minus 12 j cap. Both are valid. Okay.